हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी रिवाइज चैप्टर नंबर 4 द एग्जीक्यूटिव. ओके, सो स्टूडेंट्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज एग्जीक्यूटिव. स्टूडेंट्स, एग्जीक्यूटिव मीन टू से एग्जीक्यूटिव इज दैट ऑर्गन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट व्हिच एनफोर्सेस द विल ऑफ द स्टेट एक्सप्रेस्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लॉज. And in fact, all of the functionaries engaged in the running of administration come under executive. Okay. Next is, what is the main function of the executive? Main function of the executive. The most important function of the government or executive is to execute the laws passed by the legislature. Okay. Next one is, mention any two powers of the Vice President of India. Students, he is the ex officio chairman of the Rajya Sabha. Second one is, he shall act as acting president in the event of occurrence of vacancy in the office of president on account of his death, resignation, removal or otherwise. Okay. Next is, distinguish between single and plural executive. Students, the executive is single when the final authority is concentrated in the hands of a single person. If we talk about the USA, the executive is single because executive powers lie with the president, but in a plural executive, executive powers lie not with the person but with the council of separate persons. Okay. In Switzerland, federal council is plural executive. Okay. Next one is, mention any two functions of the prime ministers. First one is, formation of the council of ministers. Formation of the council of ministers. Second is, distribution of portfolios. So students, formation of the council of ministers. First, an important function of the prime minister is the formation of the council of ministers. Okay. And he prepares the list of ministers according to his sweet will, and nobody can be appointed a minister against the wishes of the prime minister. Okay. Second one is, distribution of portfolios. So it's another major function of the prime minister is to distribute portfolios among the ministers, and he decides what department is to be allotted to a particular minister. Okay. Next one is, four merits of a good executive. Students, a good executive looks after the administration of law and order in the country, and the lawbreakers do not find an opportunity to carry out their evil intentions. Second is, it is to see that as far as possible, financial fluctuations are avoided. A good executive does it. And the third one is, a good executive sees the national boundaries are preserved and there is no danger from the external aggression. Okay. Okay, students, thanks. Have a nice day.